Okay, so we have Kazuya Mameda talking about the novel chiral structure realized by rotation.
Okay, so first of all, I'd like to appreciate the organizer for giving me this good opportunity. And I'm Kazuya Mameda from the University of Tokyo. Today, I'd like to talk about the crucial effect of the rotation in the QCT, especially the crucial effect for the chiral symmetry breaking. This talk is based on the collaborations with these guys and these guys. So unfortunately, I have uploaded this paper in this morning. So you can read this paper tomorrow. Okay, first of all, so we know that many examples, the QCT in the some environmental effect. For example, the temperature and density, the conceptual the quantity in the QCT thermodynamics. And also, we can consider the finite state angle. The QCD with finite state angle is a very, very hot topic, which is related to heavy iron collision experiments. And also, we can consider the magnetic field and the gravitational field as external sources. So today, in this work, I'd like to consider the rotation as a kind of an external environment. And I pick up the magnetic field and the rotation, and we discussed about the QCD thermodynamics in this environment. So the magnetic field is very important for the QCD thermodynamics because so we know that actual example where the huge magnetic field exists. For example, in heavy iron collision, we can create the huge magnetic field, and also there is a huge magnetic field in magneta on the surface and the inside. The more important thing is that these two systems has a rapid rotation, and which is related to the so for about heavy iron collision, we can discuss the chiral vortical effect. So then, if you discuss these two systems, then you have to consider not only the magnetic field, but also rotation. So we are going to our discussion. Let me review the magnetic effect to the chiral symmetry breaking. So suppose that you have attractive interaction between the quarks or fermions, and you have also large magnetic field. Then magnetic field drastically changes the structure of the chiral symmetry breaking. Namely, that as the magnetic field increases, then dynamical mass is enhanced by the magnetic field, which is named magnetic catharsis. On the other hand, if you consider the finite density system, then the situation is drastically changing. So in this case, magnetic field plays a role to suppress the dynamical mass. This phenomenon is called magnetic inhibition or magnetic catharsis. So based on the usual discussion of the magnetic inhibition or inverse magnetic catharsis, we expect the magnetic inhibition by rotation. So because if you have rotation, then energy dispersion is shifted by this value. So this is a rotational energy. And we can consider this shift as an uneffective chemical potential. So in this sense, in the rotating system, we have so in rotating system magnetic inhibition errors, and we named this phenomena, novel phenomena, rotation magnetic inhibition. In later parts, we discussed this novel phenomena. So first, this is the Dirac equation under the presence of the magnetic field and rotation. And now we have considered that there is the magnetic field along to the z direction, and also rotation axis is along to the z direction. The magnetic field is included in the covariant derivative d, and the rotational effect is included in the gamma mu and d mu and covariant derivative gamma mu. So this is comes from the so this corresponds to the covariant derivative in the curved space. And now we take the metric given by this one. And solving this Dirac equation, then we can get the dispersion relation of the fermion. So as we have expected, we have the rotational energy like chemical potential. And also in the right-hand side comes from the lambda quantization. So based on this setup, we discussed the NJM model under the presence of magnetic field and rotation. So this is an NJM model Lagrangian. And in the mean field approximation, we can get the one loop gap equation. Then solving this gap equation, we can obtain the dynamical mass as a function of magnetic field and rotation. And so we know that NJL model in finite density leads to four weak coupling. The NJL in finite density leads to the magnetic catalysis. On the other hand, four strong coupling NJL in finite density leads to magnetic inhibition. So following this definition, we can check these two cases with rotation. The first is a weak coupling case at zero temperature. So these three line, three arrows means that dynamical mass is increased by the increased as a magnetic field increased. So this is corresponds to the magnetic catalysis. And also, if you have large rotation, then dynamical mass is suppressed. So this is quite similar to the case of finite density. The next is strong coupling result at zero temperature. So oppositely, the four finite with finite omega, you can see the suppression of the dynamical mass as the magnetic field increases. So this is a rotational magnetic inhibition we made. And finally, we have to mention how rotation affects the fermions. So So similarly to the finite density case with finite chamber potential, the omega is introduced into the some dynamics through the Fermi distribution function. Therefore, at the zero temperature, omega appears in the, only in the step function. So it means that if there exists the mode that satisfies this relation, then rotation affects the fermion dynamics. So otherwise, fermion leaves nothing. rotation leaves nothing. And first, let us consider the huge magnetic field compared with the scale of the system size. In this case, the wave function of fermions is quite localized. It means that R is finite, but R can be regarded as an infinitely large quantity. So in this case, we can get we can realize the lambda quantization, and we can get the eigenmode like this. And this dispersion means that this dispersion has a lambda zero mode. So in that sense, the epsilon can be zero. So in this sense, the rotation with some large huge magnetic field always affects the system. However, the case without a magnetic field is completely changing, because the wave function is no longer localized. So therefore, the R should be finite. So then, the eigenmode of the fermion is given by this form. Now, psi R is a wave function of fermions, and J L means the Bessel function, L is the Bessel function. And if you impose the if you impose the Dirichlet type boundary condition, then the perpendicular momentum is quantized by this form. So psi lk means that the case zero of the Bessel function JL. Okay, then now we can check the IR mode, infrared mode. So taking the m equals pz equals zero, then the lowest energy, lowest mode given by the psi L1 over R. And so now we are considering our the rotation, then we have the causality, the omega R smaller than one. So it means that IR mode, the lowest IR mode is should be smaller than this value. And surprisingly, this quantity is always positive because of the property of the Bessel zero. For example, psi 01 equals to 2.4 blah blah blah, which is larger than 1/2. So it means that rotation itself leads to nothing. I mean, without the magnetic field, the rotation cannot be changed as some dynamics, at least at zero temperature. And this is summary of my talk. The first, rotation itself never changes the dynamics, at least at zero temperature. However, once magnetic field is applied, then the system with magnetic field and the rotation is quite similar to the magnetic field with finite density. And for high magnetic field or at the high temperature, we can ignore the boundary effect. So for high T case, the Wilenkin is discussed that the chiral vortical current for high T case. And if you want to discuss the thermodynamics with a small electron, a small magnetic field or at low temperature, then we have to consider the boundary effect. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, questions? Any questions?
Yeah. So we were studying constant magnetic fields in a constant rotation.
Yeah.
I wonder whether there are constraints because magnetic fields and rotations are not totally independent because magnetic fields transform as a tensor rank 2 under Hodel transformation. So there should be, just from relativistic invariance, some constraints between the systems, but probably not being constant.
In the lesser frame, they're independent. They are independent, of course. And after the transformation of the coordinate, of course, these two are related. Yeah. This is included in this calculation.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, any other questions? The question I have. Different question. Okay, thank the speaker again.
No. Well, we have the poster session now outside, and there will be wine and some crisps, I guess.
Okay, so that's it. Thank all the speakers. This is supposed to be...